The rumors keep coming about potential partnerships going forward between Xbox and who knows who. Since the acquisition of Bethesda, there has been continuous rumors swirling around about who would be next in terms of an acquisition or a partnership with Xbox, because they aren't done yet. And before we get into this any further, if you guys are new here and you enjoy what you see throughout this video, I'd really appreciate you hitting that subscribe button to help this channel grow and help grow this community. So this rumor comes via a tweet from Jez Corden, and Jez Corden is a tech blogger and editor at Windows Central's. He is also a part of the Xbox 2 podcast with Randall Thor 19. And here is what he says. Don't count out Xbox Global Publishing either. Some really interesting partnerships in the works. Now, the rumors have been swirling around for a very long time with multiple different publishers that Xbox was either going to acquire or join a partnership with. The biggest one of all, and the one that I would love to see the most in terms of a partnership, which would probably be most likely, would be Sega. And this little thing here he has at the end of his tweet, people are saying, looks like the Dreamcast logo. So he's kind of hinting towards Sega. I just think their relationship is already really good with Sega. They're already putting games on Game Pass with the Yakuza series. They're giving Xbox access to Phantasy Star Online 2. It just seems like a match made in heaven. I mean, they've had a long-lasting relationship that goes all the way back to the Dreamcast when Sega and Microsoft collaborated on the console. But besides Sega, there has been other rumors. For example, we remember this picture here where Phil Spencer was talking at the Microsoft gaming event, and in the background, he had a bunch of stuff that sparked a ton of rumors, and one of them was that they were going to be doing something with Kojima Productions because they had a statue of Ludens, who is the mascot of Kojima Productions. We've seen this here, ACG on a podcast said that he had some information about something going on between Xbox and a studio. And then Special Ed from the Xbox Era podcast did some digging and tweeted this out, and he said he was fairly certain he was talking about Techland and Dying Light 2, even though after a PR representative from Techland said that that wasn't the case. And this was the tweet from Unsi, however you say it, who is actually the community manager at Techland, saying that I'm getting lots of DMs about Dying Light acquisition, so I'll answer here. There was the same rumor floating around the internet 1 year ago, and the situation didn't change. Techland is an independent studio and was not acquired by another publisher. And people saying this spells those rumors, and then you have other people saying that, hey, he's just a community manager. He's not gonna know about any of these back-end deals until they're pretty much complete. And then we see a lot of people thinking about Ubisoft, as Ubisoft has been in the rumors a lot recently with Xbox. The rumor being that they are going to be bringing over their subscription service over to Xbox Game Pass, like EA did with EA Play. And I 100% that Xbox is not done with either a partnership or an acquisition. I mean, we've even just seen Outriders bringing over their game to Xbox Game Pass on day one, and that's Square Enix as the publisher. So hey, even maybe Square Enix is one of the publishers that Jez could be referring to in that tweet. And then Phil Spencer comes out and tweets this, saying that glad to see the games industry coming together again in June for a digital E3. He's referring to the fact that E3 is happening. It's going to be free. It's going to be digital. So make sure to sign up for that if you want to watch it. And this and other summer events are proof that our industry is strongest when we work together. Looking forward to sharing what we have in store this summer. Meaning that we're gonna see a lot of stuff this E3, and maybe E3 is where some of these announcements are going to come out that have been swirling around in the rumors for a very long time. I'm happy to see that Xbox is participating in E3, just for the fact that, I mean, it brings back so much nostalgia. E3 in general is always that time of the year where you get excited to see all of the new stuff coming out in gaming. But I think Xbox's event at E3 is gonna be pretty massive in terms of showing off some Xbox Game Studio games, including the Bethesda titles that we're still waiting to see more about. And then potentially, hey, maybe they're going to talk about some further partnership and increasing the value that is already being given to us through the Xbox Series consoles and through Xbox Game Pass. But anyways, guys, I just wanted to talk about this because these rumors continue to swirl around, and it's fun to talk about what could be coming down the line at Xbox. We know Phil Spencer is making big moves. MLB The Show coming over to Game Pass on day one, to me, is a massive move. And they aren't stopping. Microsoft is fully invested in gaming. They want to continue to improve Xbox Game Pass, to improve the Xbox platform, and give a really high value driven product to the consumers. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments below. Let me know what you think about what Jez is referring to in his tweet here. Let me know what studio you would like to see either be acquired or enter into a partnership with Xbox. Thank you guys all for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe. It really does help just to get my channel out there and get more people to see it. I definitely see it in the analytics. When there's more engagement, the more my channel gets out there. And hey, the more the community grows so we can just continue to have these awesome conversations. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for your support, and I'll catch you in the next video.